making the case was fairly simple. Two pieces of plywood. These two supports go underneath the air box, and these two hold up the bellows and the reservoir. Air box fits in here like that, and fits in on this side like that. These are attached to the air box. This sits down in the base, and then there's a piece that goes across the front to support the pipes and the back of the organ, and in my case that holds the motor. As a reminder, this is a picture of the back of the organ, which also serves as a motor mount. This is the piece that I made to support the 17 pipes in the front of the organ. It's cut out to lighten the organ and to allow sound to come out from the bass pipes. The 17 pipes are only supported at the top. There's a gap behind the pipes and at the lower front of the organ. I then painted this black to give good contrast to the pipes. I wasn't thinking when I absentmindedly wrote the notes of the pipe on the top of each pipe and magic marker. I didn't want that to be visible from the front of the organ, so I made top caps for each pipe using the mahogany scraps. Birch plywood is pretty dry, and it can soak up your finish like a sponge. I used Def Lacquer sanding sealer. I brushed this on, let it dry. Sanded the surface with a random orbital, put a second coat on it, let it dry, sanded it again. Then I used good old cheap Krylon paint from Walmart. This is Hunter Green. When I put this on, first thing I do is I go around and I spray all the edges. Then I spray this back and forth this way. While it's still wet, I come back and I spray it back and forth in this direction. And let it dry. Look at it. And 15-20 minutes later, do the same thing again. And I'll let that dry overnight and come back and look at it. Two or three coats is probably all you're going to need. If it still looks kind of rough, I would hit it with a random orbital and give it two more coats and then call it good. This is the top of the organ. You can see it has a pretty good shine to it. This paint is going to get scuffed up. You're going to be grabbing the organ by the handles, your fingernails. It's going to scuff the paint up. So any organ that's being played, it's not going to look like new very long. This looks pretty good, and I'm going to let it go at that. Try to keep things square when you assemble this. It'll make life a lot easier when you go to make the other parts fit. The 17 pipes with the top caps in place, and you can see why I spray painted the inside of this black to give it that shadow box effect. This is all the tubes sticking through the pipe support. It's time to glue the window into the lid for the pressure box. I masked this off with masking tape on both sides. Took my piece of plexiglass and put silicone all the way around, and took a tool similar to this and made sure that that plastic was wet on all this surface, on this edge and the flat all the way around. Then wearing a pair of gloves, carefully set this in here and then push it into place. And you have to push it down, and that silicone will squeeze out all along this edge and on this side, and you have to try and get that surface even with this wood, and that may be difficult because you're going to have a layer of silicone between the plastic and the wood. But get it down there as tight as you can, and then I'm going to let this set up, and then I'm going to peel away this masking tape, try to clean up that silicone, and then finally remove this plastic protective coating from the plexiglass. Also, when you're pressing this in place, don't get too carried away pushing on this. This is a very thin section. If you break that after all your work in making it, you'll be very unhappy. Plus, you'll have a very sticky, gooey mess that'll be next to impossible to clean up on this inside flange. So be gentle with that. Don't crack it or break it. One other reminder, these two wires that push down on the paper roll were inserted when this box was glued together. So you gotta be real careful. Don't bend these. Chances of straightening those out again are not very good. Be gentle with these, and then also try not to get any silicone on them. I'm gonna let this sit for a couple of days, let everything dry before I remove the masking tape. I removed the masking tape on both sides. And if you look at this seam, you don't see any air bubbles, a little bit up in here, but that's a good squeeze out on the silicone, and there's a good joint between the plastic and the wood, and the masking tape prevented the silicone from sticking to the wood on either side. The pressure is on the inside. The pressure is pushing against the plastic. It'll make that even tighter, and we're talking about very little pressure. The tracker bars have been rounded over, sanded smooth, and given two coats of lacquer on both sides. There are different ways to attach the tracker bar. You do not want to screw it directly to the base because we need to be able to adjust it. I've chosen to use these little threaded studs. I got a wood screw on one end and an 832 on the other. The tracker bar has a rubber gasket around here. This is material used by the CNC guys to hold their parts down on a vacuum table. That goes on there. I got a little side-to-side adjustment. This is very, very solid that way. And I'm going to use these little fender washers. These are stamped. They got a rough side and they got a smooth side. Put the smooth side against the wood. I have the four washers and the four nuts in place. I don't want to tighten that down until I know for sure where this is going to be. With a roll of music in there. The key measurement is 1.5 inches from this face. So that's about 1 9/16. That's about 1 7/16. Right about there is 1.5 inches. So we'll just tighten that up a little bit, finger tight. I'll tighten that the rest of the way when I get the music in there. This is a test roll from Melvin Wright. It also has a lineman on it. If I bring that across, those holes are lining up perfectly. And those holes are lining up perfectly. So that's good. I'm going to go ahead and tighten down that tracker bar. I've installed the reservoir spring. I put a piece of tape across the tracker bar because nothing is connected to the tubes on the other side. I just want the tape on here to block the holes. I'm going to close this lid and then turn the crankshaft half a turn at a time just to see how everything is pressuring up. I put my thumb over this hole. I'm turning the crankshaft 1/2 turn at a time. Then release the pressure. So I'm just cycling one bellows at a time. That's pressuring up pretty well. I've sanded this on both sides and applied one coat of lacquer sanding sealer. This will be sanded again, and then I'll apply the spray paint. This has been taped off to leave a clean edge so I can glue the trim strips on the front. This is my hand wheel adapter. This is 1 inch in diameter. There are two set screws and tighten onto the shaft. This piece of wood is 5/8 inch thick. It will eventually have a groove machined into it for the belt drive. And then the hand wheel screws onto this. The next step is to go around and see if we have any air leaks. Now that I have the cranking wheel attached, I put a piece of tape across the tracker bar and I left the last hole open, which leads to a 1/4 inch piece of tubing. Put a piece of tape over the hole where the rewind mechanism will be. I close the lid and I crank. What you're hearing is the air rushing out of a single 1/4 inch brass tube on the bottom of the tracker bar. When I turn the cranking wheel, the system is able to keep up with that, and this goes all the way up to the relief valve and starts tripping it. When I first tried this system, this was running at over 10 inches of water, which was way too much. I've taken this spring and I've decreased its strength a little bit, and now this thing is going up to about somewhere between 6 and 7 inches of water, which I think will be about right. The other problem was that this spring was not putting enough pressure against this relief valve and it was blowing open from the air pressure. So I put a little more curvature in that. That puts a little more pressure down. And I'm fairly happy with that. When this was operating at 10 inches of water, I was getting air, a lot of air coming out through this pressure box lid and other places. And once I dropped the pressure down to the 6 to 7 inch pressure range, things have settled down quite a bit. The next step is to retune the base pipes, get them mounted back in the back of the organ, and then we'll start voicing and tuning the 17 pipes for the front. Originally, I had this painted black, but when I completed the front panel fretwork, you really couldn't see the details of the cutouts very well. So I painted this yellow. When the pipes are installed, there won't be a lot of that visible. I also added these 4 holes to allow the sound from the bass pipes to come forward. And when this is turning, you can see the bellows work and you can see the crankshaft going around. It gives a little more visual interest from the front of the organ. Each of these pipes was voiced and tuned on the organ. I cut the pipe to the final length, painted the tuning plugs, and then tomorrow I'll reinstall the tuning plugs in the pipes, tune each one again, and then install it in the organ.